This is a balance, not a scale, used for measuring mass. It's a double pan equal arm balance. This is a triple beam unequal arm balance, also used for measuring mass. Remember that mass is the amount of matter or inertia in an object, measured on a balance, units or kilograms, and it doesn't change. This is a scale. It's for force, sometimes for weight. Here's another type of scale, also for force and weight. In contrast with mass, weight is the force of gravity on an object measured using a scale, and it changes depending on where you go in the universe. Here's one example of a scale. It's a good scale measured in newtons. Here's another example of a scale. It's another good scale. The units are pounds force in the English system, newtons in the metric system. But since mass and weight, scales, and balances are always confused, here's an example of a bad scale given to us by a scientific supply house. It has both grams, mass, and newtons, force, or weight, on the same scale. Here's another one. I call it a bad scale because it says it's a balance, but it's definitely not. It's a scale. Here's one that looks pretty good. And for some of these, I scraped off the grams on the backside. Front side looks really great. That's the good side. It says newtons in it. And then the bad side is the grams side. Remember that the rest of the world uses the metric system, where mass is in kilograms, and weight and force are in newtons. Unfortunately, in most other countries, if you ask them how much they weigh, they will give you a number in kilograms, because 100 kilograms sounds a whole lot better than 1,000 newtons. This scale measures in pounds force and in kilograms, and adds even more to the confusion. And to bring it all to a horribly unconclusory conclusion, remember the last time you went to the nurse or the doctor's office and they measured your weight on a scale? Yeah, they were using one of these and they were measuring your mass on a balance. And unfortunately, the people in charge of the English system decided that they didn't like the old unit of slug and decided to go with a new unit called pounds also. So we have pounds force and pounds mass. They happen to be the same value at sea level. On the moon, your pounds mass value would stay the same, but your pounds force weight would be 1/6 as much. So remember, this is a balance for mass, kilograms in the metric system. And this is a scale for weight, newtons in the metric system. Here's another type of scale. And although I want you to think of mass as constant, if something is moving near the speed of light relative to you, turns out that your measurement of its mass would not be the same as its rest mass. Einstein, 1905.